कमिंग टू पेज नंबर 69, स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ अ सीड. सो अ सीड कंसिस्ट ऑफ थ्री मेन पार्ट विच इज सीड कोट, नंबर सेकेंड एंडोस्पर्म एंड द थर्ड वन इज एम्ब्रियो. इफ आई एम टॉकिंग अबाउट अ सीड कोट, सीड कोट इज द हार्डर आउटर कोट ऑफ अ सीड. द डार्क ब्राउन पार्ट ऑफ अ सीड, द हार्डर कोट ऑफ अ सीड दैट कवर्स एंड प्रोटेक्ट्स द एम्ब्रियो फ्रॉम इंजरी एंड ड्राइंग आउट. फॉर द प्रोटेक्शन ऑफ एम्ब्रियो फ्रॉम डैमेज, सीड कोट इज कंपल्सरी. नंबर सेकेंड एंडोस्पर्म. एंडोस्पर्म इज फूड स्टोरिंग पार्ट एंड फूड सप्लाई ऑफ द प्लांट. इट मीन्स एंडोस्पर्म इज यूज टू सप्लाई फूड टू द प्लांट एंड टू स्टोर फूड एंड इट सराउंड्स द एम्ब्रियो एंड प्रोवाइड फूड फॉर इट्स ग्रोथ. कमिंग टू एम्ब्रियो. Embryo is the baby plant that grows into a new plant under right conditions. Cotyledons are the newly formed leaf-like part. It is also called a seed leaf. As we can see, embryo, the green part inside the seed, is called embryo. It is the baby plant. Which grows into a new plant. Coming to monocotyledons and dicotyledons plants. First of all, we should know the meaning of mono and di. Mono means one. Mono represents one and di represents two. So we can say monocot plants have a single cotyledon and seeds of dicot plants have two cotyledons. For example, you can see in the picture as well that the seed coat of monocot and dicot are same, but monocot seed has a single cotyledon and dicot seed has double cotyledons. And in monocot seed, it stores food in just one part, but in dicot seed, it stores food in two parts. Moving on to stem. Stem of dicots and monocots work for the same purpose, to provide strength for it to stand upright. It means the outer part of the stem works the same purpose, as they have a vascular system of xylem and phloem. Xylem and phloem are the tissues. What is the function of xylem? To provide water. And what is the function of phloem? To supply food for the rest of the plant. But if we talk about the internal structure of the stems, they are different. How they are different? We are moving on page number 17. In a monocot plant, these vessels are scattered throughout the stem, but a dicot plant have an organized ring formation of these vessels, as you can see easily in the pictures as well, that in monocot, phloem and cambium, these are tissues present in monocot stem. Phloem, cambium, xylem, these are the tissues present in dicot stem. So they are different from each other. Their stem, internal structure of the stem is different from each other. If we talk about monocot leaf and dicot leaf, how they are different? Dicot plant has a net-like vein system, whereas the leaf of a monocot plant has parallel veins. As their leaf structure are also different. You can see in the pictures as well. Coming on to flower. That how can a monocot flower and a dicot flower can be different. If the number of petals are divided by 3, then we can say these are the monocot flowers. But if the number of petals can be divided by 4 or 5, they are said to be dicot plants. Moving on to page number 71. Roots. Okay, so how are the roots of monocot and dicot different? Dicots have the tap root, as you can see in the picture as well, whereas monocots have the fibrous roots. Examples of monocot plants include palm tree, grass, and daffodil. These are the examples of monocot plants. Moving on to examples of dicot plants, which is neem, cabbage, and spinach. They are the examples of dicot plants. So here our topic ends. I hope you all are cleared with this topic. Thank you, everyone.